Damn.
That was Roses Unread, and they happen to be in the studio with us.
Oh. What's up, guys?
Hey, guess what?
We made it.
They are playing at the Juke Joint tonight with the other LA. And so we took the opportunity that we were doing this show anyways because Love the Hate wanted to do the show. And I was like, okay, here's an opportunity to get the bands that we've played before and talked to before that are actually in town. Let's see if we can make it happen.
Yes.
And lo and behold, here you guys are.
Well, we are so happy to be here. So thank you guys for having us up for a little bit.
No,
sure. Like it's our pleasure. All our pleasure.
Super stoked. Now, where exactly are you guys from?
We are from...
That is a great question.
Tennessee.
Because I was going to say we had this conversation the last time you were on the show, which was two years ago. Almost.
Don't even look at me,
yes,
dude.
Yes. It's been serious? A long time. Yes. Right. But it's still Tennessee because we're in Brownsville, Tennessee, which is like 30 minutes from Jackson, an hour from Memphis. And Rocky, our drummer, he just moved to Tennessee.
Okay.
And then Jed still lives in Mississippi, so he's
To clarify, you know, I moved 10 minutes down the road. It just happened to be across the Mississippi to the Tennessee border.
Nice.
So I lived in South Haven, Mississippi, which is you know, right beside Memphis.
Yeah, and I'm stuck in Corinth, so.
Okay. All right. Well, Tennessee's a great state, too, so no hard feelings there.
We love
there.
It.
Corinth.
Yeah.
I've been there.
Yeah.
That's where Saving Abel came out.
And if you ask them, that is Corinth, not Corinth.
Yeah.
Corinth, Mississippi.
I did some time in Oxford for a little while.
Gotcha. So,
yeah, I've been up there.
But anyway. I love
totally
Oxford.
Totally different feel.
Yeah. I was a little different for them people up there, I think. A little different. But anyway. So, yeah.
So, is this y'all's first time playing the Juke Joint?
Yes.
Because I was talking to the guy that books the Juke Joint last night, and he couldn't remember if you guys had been there
No,
before.
No, we'd never been there. We are happy. Yeah, we're happy to be here. And we came up yesterday and just kind of made a mini vacation out of it. So, like, we hit the beach and hit the strip. And so had a good
hit
time.
Hit the casinos?
We did.
Yes.
Jed lost all his money.
I hear you.
Jed lost all his rent money.
Okay, good. That's what you're supposed to do.
Yeah. And we just laughed at him.
I'm over here looking at the comments. Comments are blowing up for you guys.
You got people all over the place here.
Nice. Yeah, we shared it on our page before we came up. Yeah.
If there's a whole bunch of that, I'm just going to... We get to disappoint a whole bunch of people.
Oh, damn it.
Well... I don't think that's the truth because everybody's lighting it up down there. That's pretty cool. So so Juke Joint tonight.
Yes.
Excited about that?
We are. It's our first time actually playing on the Gulf Coast.
Oh, okay. Okay.
So like we've played all over Mississippi, but never actually played on the Gulf Coast.
Well, the Juke Joint is a great place to, can I say pop your cherry on this show, Kevin? I'm not sure if I could say that. Oh, but anyway.
It's getting popped tonight.
I don't want to be fucking rude. You know what I'm saying?
Well,
anyway, it's a great place. They're actually a sponsor of the show. We love Guido and the guys over there at the Juke Joint. They're very hospitable. The venue is great, and we just did our show there last weekend. It was a great time. Yep. Weather was a little shitty, but we still persevered and had fun, so it's going to be a good time for sure.
Yep. Weather has cooperated so far this weekend.
I think it will.
So,
Kevin and I don't have anything going on,
I guarantee you that's why we had to take tarp down yesterday.
Yeah, because the weather was nice.
They're going to play outside and the weather's going to be nice.
Sure. Hey, I'm
so our show. Have you been there yet?
No.
Okay. So when you walk out, back, there's this huge stage and it's wide open. So we had four bands playing outside last week and it was raining. So we bought this 28-foot by 59-foot tarp and ran it from the roof of the
stage.
Yeah.
Out and then just tied it off to the building.
I bet that was fun to put up.
We got to give big credit to Dustin. I know he's out there watching.
Was it raining while you put the tarp up?
Yes.
Sprinkling.
Okay.
Lights.
Okay.
And that's what really sucked is it was all week. It was 15% chance of rain. Then Friday night it was a 70% chance of rain. Then it went to a 50% chance of rain, and then it never really rained after we put the tarp up. So.
Yeah, it never did, but that's how you have to do things. Kevin, you got a compliment on your Cobra Kai t-shirt. I just want to go ahead and say that.
Yeah, Rocky and I are huge Cobra Kai fans.
Yes.
the video that you guys just saw lying to yourself, I've got some BTS footage that I was going through, and Rocky and I are like karate chopping the shit out of each other. But and that
I
was
tell
because,
him all the time, I said, don't make me Cobra Kai you.
Yes, and
I
that mean, was yeah. And we had just watched, I think, the second season right. of that show, like right before we shot that video. So, you know, right when Rocky wasn't looking, I was like, you know, better watch out.
I will say this now that you brought the video up. I love the that it was a white room.
Yeah.
And then, of course, everybody was in their colors and things like that. That was a very unique way of shooting that video. I loved it.
The team we had for that video, I was telling the guys out there, the team we had for that video was incredible. And that day, like, the video turned out great. But the day before we shot that video, a day or two before we shot that video, the AC went out in that room. Oh. And it's a giant garage that they painted white. And they like pull trucks in there and take pictures and videos of trucks for Rough Country, like the lift organization, you know,
right,
make
right, right.
truck lifts and stuff. Right. Everybody in Mississippi knows who Rough
Country
is.
Oh, yeah, they do.
But so we get there and it's like, it feels like it does out there today. And it starts raining a little bit, so it's super, super humid. And they're like, oh, the AC went out. And we're like, gosh. And then, well, yeah, you got to play the song like 30 times.
Uh-huh.
And
time
so,
to sweat.
Dude, and it was, and her makeup was running. So, like, we've got the best makeup artist. Shout out to Rachel, because Allison looks great in the video. And the video turned out amazing. And that was one of those songs that it wasn't, when we recorded that EP in 2000 and put it out in 2019, the song's called Lying to Yourself. And it was one of our favorite songs, but it wasn't the song that we thought was just going to pop off. And then when we put that video out, everybody was like, holy crap. And that's the video it just hit like 100,000 views on YouTube recently, which nice. For like a completely independent band, that's like huge,
yes.
you know?
Yep,
and, so yeah, that was the song that in, you know, in the video, we found our art director, December Hansen, who's incredible. She found the two twins and in the video or the songs about, like, you know, internal struggles and stuff. So we found two twins that could actually, you know, wrestle and fight and stuff. And it's awesome.
They were cheerleaders in high school.
Nice.
Yeah. Gotcha. They also really fought too.
Yeah.
Yeah. One of their we had like an earring ripped out by the end of the day.
Oh wow.
And yeah. One of them hurt their neck or something.
The knocking over the TV wasn't planned either. It just happened.
He hit his back.
Yeah. Anything that got broke, that was not intentional.
No. None of us got hurt though. So I mean, that's all I'm worried.
Yeah. That like wrestling's not in my contract. Yeah.
Right.
So now the touring's back. I want to say fully, I don't know if it's fully back,
that's coming.
So for 2020 to 2021 to where we're at now, what did you guys do a lot during that pandemic era?
Wrote a lot.
Yeah, we wrote, Allison and I wrote a lot. The four of us did not get in the same room together until November of 2020 when we recorded the song that we're dropping. What is it? It's not this coming.
It's June 21st.
June 21st. We're dropping a brand new song. And that song was what brought the four of us together during the pandemic, because Allison and I started writing it. And then Allison had written a ton of songs. And then she and I were working on them. And then we started showing them to Rocky and Jed. And the song's called Leave a Light On. And we showed that to Rocky and Jed. And they were like, hold up a second. What's this? And so that was the song we went in the studio in November and recorded. And I think we got together two or three weeks before we actually recorded that song. And that was the first time the four of us had been in the same room together since like January. 'Cause we had like a New Year's Eve show. And like, I think we opened up for Diamante in Memphis in February of 2020. And then it was like, yeah. And then
we,
like, bam, sorry.
No, you're good,
you're
good.
You're excited over there.
And then, you know, and then it was like nothing the rest of the year. And so that's all. And then Allison started a Twitch channel. And so that's how she started.
She just got a compliment on it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Well, I was going to ask, what's that all about? What's somebody's complimenting how badass your Twitch channel is. So what are we doing on that thing?
Sepsis, shout out to them, because they're in, I'm watching them in the comments. They're another awesome band that Twitches too. They have a female friend too.
We follow them on Twitch.
Yeah. So yeah, definitely check them out if you haven't. And they're going to go on tour with like OTIP. So it's pretty cool.
Right. Oh, shit. No shit. Are you serious?
Uh-huh.
Woo!
Sepsis are the hands down.
And they're
down
on Blind Anxiety too.
Okay.
Yeah. So we're all kind of in the community. But they started the Twitch thing, and then I was like, that's a good idea. And I saw some other bands doing it, so I started one. And they have a really good following. They've been doing it a while.
We're on Twitch right now, just a little FYI.
Oh, cool.
Kevin and I are still struggling to figure that
whole thing out. It's such a great platform.
What do y'all do on there, though? Is it just you? Is it full band practices? Is it you talk? I mean, like, what's your format?
It's a lot of me writing. Like, I'll have my piano or the guitar. Sometimes I'm making jewelry. Sometimes I'm doing art. I started a new hobby, rock tumbling, which everybody hates because the rock tumblers are so loud. So I'm going to make jewelry.
I love rock tumbling. Yes. I was raised in the Air Force. I was an Air Force brat. So part of my young life was in Arizona. In Phoenix and Mesa and Tucson. So my dad had rock tumblers. We'd find the rocks and
three
shine
of them,
them up, yep. And
they're going that. Right now.
Three of them. Yeah, I just left them unattended at the house. I'm like, no, they're fine. They're not going to blow up.
You know, that's one thing we've never mentioned on the show, though.
What, rock tumbling?
that's number one. Number two is like we talk about social media. Obviously, we're a live stream show on the internet, and it's great that we always promote bands to be as active as they can on social media. Some are more than others, and I think everybody should push as hard as they can.
Right.
But when you go across multiple platforms, understanding the dynamics of each audience on those platforms is very important. And for me to hear you say, like, on Twitch, it's not just it's not the same thing maybe you're pushing out on Facebook, right?
Right.
It's different, and it's a little bit more probably your personality, something that you're into specifically. Mm-hmm. And fans love that. Yep. They want to know more about the individuals of each band. And exactly. So to see you utilizing it that way, I think is pretty kick ass.
Yeah. Our YouTube is mostly like Rocky and I are just like the last couple of years, Rocky and I are really, really getting into videography. So all of our music videos and a lot of our like vlogs and documentaries that Rocky and I have done are on our YouTube channel. And then Twitch and Patreon, that's like Allison's thing. That's like if you really just want to know more about Allison than you care to know, like you get on, you like become a patron, and she'll like, she does this rock tumbling, and she sends her patrons like the rocks that she spends like a month.
Cool. Well, I make now jewelry out of them.
Yeah, and she makes jewelry, and then like the bigger rocks she can't make, you know, a ring out of. She'll send them, and then she'll make other stuff. And then like the Instagram and the Facebook, I'm mostly running, and a lot of that stuff is like I'm kind of an amateur photographer, so I take these like really candid shots of like Rocky's drums and like Jed playing bass and like Allison, you know, doing stuff that Allison does, you know, besides rock tumbling, hopefully. And then so like you said, like the different platforms we use, they each have a little bit different feel to them. And then our personal Facebook pages are just like a shit show.
There you go. So and that's what it should be. Should be.
Don't forget our photographer is actually in the studio with us now.
Kevin.
He helps supply the Instagram with a lot of photos.
Yeah. And so. Kevin's like our live photographer because.
Yeah. Come have it. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, sit down right there.
The type of photography that like Rocky and I
are. Oh, yeah. There we go. Yeah.
Rocky and I are good at like, you know, if you pose and like, okay, we can do that. Like Kevin's really good about, you know, capturing moving stuff and doing that. And I can't, and none of us can do that. So Kevin is always in the van with us. He's always on the road with us. He is a invaluable part of our team. So this is Dreadhead Kev.
Yeah, I got hair envy, Kev. Sorry, man. It's pretty slick up under here, bro. But
he's shot for he's done shoots for like Seether and Skillet, and so he did a lot of wrestling and stuff before he came on board with us. So
nice.
Kevin is We're happy to have Kevin.
I'm glad to hear y'all say all of that though, because our audience is unsigned. You know, we promote unsigned artists, new rock. I mean, we do play signed stuff too, but you know, it's the up and coming stuff. And I really hope that if you're in a band and you're listening to the show right now, watching the show, you hear what we're saying. Like that's the new thing. Like it's not just get signed by a record label and then take off like it was in the 1980s. It's do it yourself.
It's nothing like that.
It's understand the internet, understand social media, and understand social media platforms.
Right.
Maximize them for yourself. Give your fans that behind the scenes look that you're talking about.
Right.
So write that down, somebody.
No, if record labels are not going to touch you nowadays unless you have all that established.
Can you say that again?
Record labels are not going to touch you unless you have all that established already.
Thank you. It's that's called leverage. Leverage, and that's what they want to see. So,
well, and I was looking around on some stuff earlier today and looking at places that were looking for bands and things like that. And you start reading what they're looking for. And the very first thing, social media presence.
And let me say something to that. It's like it's good and it's bad because I'm way old school. I remember when it was like go out and play as many live shows as you can and conquer your local area, right? And have people coming out. And it is still that. Yeah. But this is like another layer added on to that. So don't fight it. Just embrace it. Do both. Put on great shows, but you have to have that.
It's a full-time job. Even being like an unsigned independent band, it's a full-time job, you know, not only being on the road playing shows, but also like having a marketing plan.
Correct.
And, you know, we do all that ourselves.
It's having an image, having everything fall in line like it's supposed to be, or at least the way you want it to be. And, you know, I tell people all the time, I was like, no one cares about your band as much as you do. So if you are not out there watching every aspect of your band and making sure it is exactly what you want it to be, then I can't help you at that point, because there's nobody's going to do it as much or, you know, for the right reasons as you are going to do it for your band.
And so, like you guys have, you have your own photographer here. I mean, that's important. It's almost like another member of the band, right? You wouldn't have a band without
He is a member. Member.
He is.
Yeah. Okay. Not member. Like.
And then we have Whitney, who's not, who she's out there. Why.
Yeah. She's
basically like, saying that she's a merch girl, it would be not doing correct her justice, because correct she's so much more than that. Like, she does the Patreon with Allison. She does a lot of creative stuff that the three of us can't, you know, we like our brain doesn't work that way. So
we got a question in the comment section. This is from, was you looking at that?
Yeah.
From Stephanie Bryant. She wants to know, will y'all ever be signed or just stay independent?
I mean, we're not turning record deals down yet. Right. So,
right thing comes around, of course.
Depending on the circumstances, I guess, and
what
the offer was.
I think the important thing is, and that's a great question, by the way, because a lot of bands go out with the mentality of, man, we're going to get signed and then,
correct,
you know, but we're just like, me personally, and you know, I guess I can speak for everybody, like, we just like writing music and playing music and seeing people come out and respond to the music that we write, that we wrote, you know.
Yeah.
And to me, that's the biggest thing, and everything else is just kind of a fringe benefit, I guess.
Right.
I mean, for lack of a better term, like, that's the main thing. Like, we just like playing music and we like getting our music out there, and we like seeing people, seeing people's reactions. And we love the stories of, this song means so much to me because this happened while I was listening to this song. You know, those stories, you can't put a price on that.
That's right.
So, but yeah, like, you know, if we're not turning record labels down, if something came along and it was like totally worth, you know, in addition to what the time we've already put into it, then we would, For sure. entertain that idea.
It's got to be the right deal, and it's got to benefit y'all just as much as it would the record label.
But I mean, we're not sweating it at the same time. You know, we're out here just doing what we want to do, and you know, we're not relying on anybody else to help us.
I think the big topic here is that knowing that just being signed is not validation.
Right.
A band right now prior to being signed. Right. I mean, there's a ton of things that you can do. You, every other band, every other musician who's out there listening without being signed.
Well, I mean, the greatest example, you guys have just showed the Lying to Yourself music video. I mean, would you guys consider that a high caliber video?
Absolutely.
I mean,
exactly.
We have no label that was funded by us.
Correct.
And I mean,
you get to keep more percentage of your profit.
Exactly. So, you know, you don't have to have a record deal in order to do it, you know.
Correct.
As they would say, you know, to do the damn thing, you don't have to have a record label to do it. You know, everything we've done has been, you know, this band has, we have worked hard enough to get to a point where this band is self-sufficient. It pays for itself. And, you know, that's amazing. You know, when we want to do music videos, record albums, record singles, you know, go tour, we don't have to have something funding it to do it. It funds itself. So
that's it.
You know,
it took us a long time to get there, but and we messed up more stuff than we'd like to admit. But I mean, we, like Rocky said, we're to the point now where we've got the best fans in the world, and they're very generous and with the shares and the likes and the comments and joining Allison's Patreon, and that all goes right back into it, and that, you know, puts out music videos that gives us we're constantly you know, putting out new music. If we're we're going to be putting out, constantly putting out new music this year and next year.
Kevin and I typically like to ask, you know, where can we send the audience? Where can they go find you? But I think we've already covered that. I mean, y'all are on all the platforms. And yeah. It sounds to me like active on all in different, like we said, in different ways.
Your platform of choice, we're probably on it. Twitter, we're not that active on. But rosesunreadofficial.com is like our hub. It's there, got you go. Instagram, tour dates, YouTube, merch store. That's like the hub for, you know, wherever else you want to go. So
the YouTube is great because not only do we put the videos on there, but like he was talking about, which of course 2020 we didn't have many up because we weren't around each other. We weren't touring.
Yeah.
But we got in this habit where at least every couple of weeks we would do a 15 or a 20 minute blog. Mm-hmm. And there's lots of funny stuff in those because I mean, doing this is funny. You know, it's, you know, we had a show where we played in the mud pretty much and it rained for 2 days straight. And, you know, we come home and it's like, you know, no one talks about having to unload all of your gear and clean mud out of cases and stuff like that, you know, that took an entire day to do. Right. No one talks about that.
And the funny thing about that is while Rocky and I were, because that particular show, and I don't like to badmouth anybody, but that particular show, the venue like straight up lied to us and was like, yeah, this is what the stage is going to look like, and sent us this picture. And we're like, that's awesome. And we get there and that's not what the stage looked like. And
it's plywood.
It was plywood with a tarp over, and there was nowhere to store equipment. So our equipment got rained on, it got mud in it. Then the next day, Rocky and I are pissed, getting all the gear out, like cleaning the casters off, cleaning, you know, mud out of all of our gear. And then I start getting text messages saying like, oh, Jared Dines put you in one of his music video or his YouTube videos. So, yeah,
my wife shared that and she's like, hey, check this out. And I was like, oh, okay, cool. They shared something. I was like, oh, wait, no, that's Jared Dines. Oh, wait, that's us.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
But that's the way it works. And so we've kind of moved more, instead of doing like a vlog style thing, we've kind of moved more in the direction of like Instagram stories, and Allison's Twitch is going to be more of an up-to-date thing. So if you just want to keep up with any and all things that we're doing and probably learn some stuff about us, you probably wish you hadn't learned. Allison's Twitch channel is going to be the place for that.
Let's do two question speed fire questions real quick here. I'm going to read them directly out of the comment section. It says, will John ever play anything other than a PRS?
I'm a huge Fender fan.
Okay.
Yep.
And it says, why does John hate Mississippi barbecue so much? And who is the prettiest producer he's ever worked with? I'm not going to say who asked that.
The prettiest producer I've ever worked with is
David Cowell.
There it is, right on the bottom of the screen, ladies and gentlemen.
I was going to say, I don't think it was David Cowell.
Let me talk about Dave for a second. We call him Dave. His name's David Cowell on Facebook, but we call him Dave. And the other day, Dave's like, posted something on Facebook, and he was like, if you ask me my opinion on something, I'm going to give it to you and be honest, because that's just how Dave is, just like a super honest person. And I said, well, what is your favorite amp and recording chain for heavy downtuned guitars? And he was like, listen to what we did on your stuff. And I was like, okay, well, that's kind of the answer I wanted. And there was a PRS amp and a PRS guitar involved in that.
There you go.
But why do I hate Mississippi barbecue so much? I don't.
Yes, he does.
Look, guys.
So if I go on your Facebook, I won't find Mississippi barbecue hate memes.
No, because I'm deleting them right now. the thing about Mississippi barbecue is every time I've gone to Mississippi and somebody's been like, bro, you got to go check out this barbecue joint. And I go there and it's not, I'm like, I'm from Memphis.
Well, that's tough.
Okay.
Actually, you're from Arkansas.
I went to school in Memphis though. So I claim Memphis. I don't claim Arkansas.
Well, y'all are going to be right down the road from Murky Waters. I don't know if you have time. It's on the same street you're playing. So maybe go check that out.
I will try that.
Yeah, go check that out. I don't know. I like it. So.
You should do it like a bar stool sports shed version of barbecue.
Yeah. Sure. Yep. That'd be tight. Kevin, what else we got, man? Before we wrap things up.
Just what's up for the rest of 2021 for you guys?
We are putting out a brand new song and video that basically details our entire 2020 mindset of being lonely and isolated and like basically what the world was feeling during 2020. We're putting that out June 21st. song's called Leave a Light On. We are constant. We've been recording throughout the year. So we've got like single after single, video after video. We're constantly pushing out. We're not going to drop like an EP or an album and then it'll be like another 2 years. Like we're trying to constantly put out new content. And yeah, we're doing something with the other LA tonight at the Juke Joint. Great friends of ours. Go check them out. And then we're doing a run, doing like Indiana, Ohio, West Virginia, doing a run with them. And then just little dates sprinkled throughout the rest of the year. But yeah, definitely be on the lookout. Rocky's got some sick new merch designs he's working on. So those will be dropping hopefully very soon, depending on this guy over here. And then new music, new merch designs, and hopefully we will come see everybody as soon as we possibly can. But we're just excited to like get in a room and like talk about this stuff.
I
couldn't do it last year. Yeah.